Hello, we are at NAMM 2018 and I'm with Pete at the Strymon booth. Hi, Pete.
Hi.
So we're here to discuss about the Magneto.
Yes. Magneto is our first Eurorack module. It stemmed from the people we've seen using El Capistan in their Eurorack setups, and we thought that a tape delay Eurorack, dedicated Eurorack product would be a good idea. So we kind of started with the idea of El Capistan, and then we kept adding to it and added features and functionality and kind of went way beyond the original El Capistan concept to create Magneto. There's four heads, playback heads. Each head has an individual playback level control. Each head has individual feedback assignment. So this is similar to some old Benson magnetic machines would have independent playback and feedback switches. So you can do that here, independent feedback and more than independent assignment for the heads, independent level. We have pan options, and in the center pan, you can pan that custom so that you can have each head custom placed in the stereo field. We have these buttons also double as transport buttons, so you can get an infinite hold, a loop that continues. You can reverse the direction of the tape. You can slow it down with a pause effect that has mechanical speed that is adjustable. We have the tone shaping row down here where we have low cut tape age, the crinkle, which is tape artifacts like splices and where the tape has been kind of chewed up. And then the wow and flutter, the mechanical stability, and then the independent spring reverb. So you can actually, you can keep the delay off and you can turn this, have just a spring module. There's a lot of CV control for the speed of the tape, which is independent, can be controlled with a speed CV, which is 1 volt per octave. So you can play a keyboard to capture a loop or capture a self-oscillation and then play that with a keyboard. We have a record level control, which sends hot signals to the record head, which results in a really nice saturated, fat signal getting regenerated into the tape. So we have three different head spacings. One is even, the heads are evenly spaced. One is triplet spacing. And then one is shift head, where the heads run at differing speeds to create rhythmic pitched delays, which is kind of an interesting effect. So lots of cool stuff. You can use this as a master clock. It can slave to a clock. It integrates well with other modules, so we're excited about it.
Yeah, I guess you are. We've heard some demos, and it's definitely very impressive. So with a basic sequence, you can actually turn it like a real aerial kind of thing, which is very, very interesting. And does that mean that you're going to go more into the Eurorack world in the future?
Well, we hope to, for sure. We've been encouraged by the initial response that we've seen from Magneto. So our plan is that we will probably continue with more modules, some hopefully come up with a line that, ranges from... Well, in fact, now that we're speaking about this... right next to here is our Strymon AA1, which is, this is a prototype, but we're actually going to be shipping this in a couple of months. It's a line level shifter that allows you to integrate your guitar pedals with your Eurorack or plug your guitar straight in to be processed by Eurorack. So it's a really handy utility that we developed to kind of test Magneto with, and then we realized that this is...
That could be a product in
Italy. So this would represent maybe the smallest end of what we might do in Eurorack, and maybe this is towards the larger end, and then there's some room in between. So we're excited to really do something with this.
So maybe we're going to see guitarists go into the Eurorack world now because of you.
You never know. I mean, it seems like, it seems like there's always something coming around the corner, and it would be fun to see that happen.
And so when will the Magneto, the final version of Magneto, because it's been in the making since a while now, so when is it going to be available?
We're going to start shipping. Our production build starts in early February, so we're going to start getting them out in the U.S., hopefully by the end of February, and also start making our first international shipment. So it'll however long it takes to get from the distributors to the dealers, but it's actually within a couple of weeks. We're at the point now where it's not It's not like summer or something.
It's really close. That's what it is. So, and in terms of price, what can we expect?
In the U.S., it's the street price is $599.
Thank you for giving us all this nice explanation. That's really a lot of features packed into this new Eurorack module. So thanks, Pete, for the explanation, and see you next time.